Yes, very good. Okay, so students, let's start. Are you ready? Are you ready? Yes, yes, yes. We'll start today from question number 2A. Okay, so let's start. This is your 7, and the subject is, and we are solving simple equation. Simple equations, and the exercise number is 4.4. Today we'll start from question number 2A. Yes, question number 2A. So read the question once. Okay, the teachers tell the class that the highest marks obtained by our students in her class is twice the lowest marks, class 7. Okay, so here the key line is, the highest marks obtained by a student is twice the lowest marks, class 7. Twice the lowest marks, class 7. So the highest score is given. We have to find out the lowest score. Okay, so let us consider. Let us consider the lowest score. Lowest score is X. The lowest score is X. So what will be the highest score? What will be the highest score? Now look, according to your book, it is given that the highest score is twice the lowest score plus 7. Twice the lowest score plus 7. So what is the lowest score? X. So twice the lowest score means twice X and plus 7. Twice the lowest score plus 7. Okay? But according to problem, it is given that the highest marks means twice X plus 7 is equal to 87. Yes, already a few of you has given the right equations. Yes, so now we have to solve it. Okay, so let's solve it. Or 2X will be equal to 87, and when we shift this 7 from left hand side to right hand side, it will be minus 7. That means 2x is equal to, now 87 minus 7, that is obviously 80. That means x will be equal to 80 by 2. That means x equal to 40. So x equal to 40. That means what is the result? The lowest score is 40. The lowest score is 40. This is the answer. Now tell me, students, have you understood? If you have any problem, you can tell me. Otherwise, we'll move to the next question. Okay, a lot of students are saying, yes sir, yes sir, yes sir. Then we can go to the next question. You just have a look on the question number 2B. Look, question number 2B says that in an isosceles triangle, the base angles are equal. So, in an isosceles triangle, the base angles are obviously equal. So, tell me one thing. Do you know the definition of isosceles triangle? The definition of an isosceles triangle?
Yes.
Anyone can you tell me the definition of isosceles triangle or what is isosceles triangle? Okay. I'm giving you 1 minute to answer. What is the isosceles triangle? Two sides are same. Very good. Two sides are same. Very good. So Kursi and Adrita, Anisha, yes, right. Very good. Anudha also said two sides are equal. Yes, very good. So a triangle is said to be an isosceles triangle if its two sides are equal or two sides are same. Okay. So let us consider an isosceles triangle means a triangle whose two sides are same. So let the triangle is ABC, whose the side AB is equal to side AC. So as the triangle is isosceles triangle, so their base angles will be also equal. Base angles will be also equal. And the vertex angle is 40. Vertex angle is, according to our diagram, the vertex angle is A, which is equal to 40 degrees. We have to find what are the base angle. What are the base angle? So let us consider the base angles are x degree. Let the base angle are x degree. Means this angle is x degree and this angle is also x degree. Now try to recall the angle sum property of a triangle. What is the angle sum property of a triangle? The angle sum property of a triangle says that the sum of all interior angle of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. Isn't it? Angle sum property says that the sum of all interior angle of any triangle, the sum of all interior angle of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So here, what are the interior angle? One angle is 40 degree, one angle is x degree, one angle is x degree. So three angles are given. So we'll apply the angle sum property. So according to problem, if I add all interior angle, means angle B which is equal to x degree plus angle C which is equal to also x degree plus angle A which is equal to 40 degree, this result will be equal to 180 degree. Within the bracket we will write the reason why. By angle sum property. By angle sum property. By angle sum property. Okay, now our equation is now ready. We have to solve it. Now look, x plus x. So when we add x with another x, so the result will be 2x plus 40. That will be equal to 180. Now we have to solve it. That means 2x will be equal to 180 minus 40. Why minus 40? Because look, the sign of 40 in the left hand side is positive. So when we shift this 40 from left hand side to right hand side, its sign will be changed into minus. That means 2x will be equal to 180 minus 40, that is equal to 140. So if x equal to 140, then what will be the value of x? So value of x will be 140 by 2. That means 70. That means 70. Therefore, the base angle is 70 degrees. The base angle is 70 degrees. Yes, yes, very good. The base angle is 70 degree. Okay, now tell me, have you any problem? Otherwise, we'll move to the next question. No problem. Very good. Okay, so we'll move to the next question. It's just have a look on the question number C. Look, question number C says that Sachin scored twice as many runs as Rahul. Together, their run fell too short of a double century. Too short means two run only. So they failed double century by two run. So can you tell me what is the total run done by Sachin and Rahul? Yes, 190. Just two short from a double century. So it is 198. Okay. Now we have to find here how many runs did each of them has done. Okay. So let us consider. Let Rahul's score is X. Rahul's score is X. So what will be the Sachin score? Look, it is given that Sachin score twice as many runs as Rahul. So what will be the Sachin score? Can you tell me? Yes, it will be twice X. So Sachin score, is twice the Rahul score. Twice the Rahul score means 2X. Okay. Now together, what is the score done by them? Okay. So the total score. So the total score will be score of Sachin, which is equal to 2X, plus score of Rahul, which is equal to X. So this is the total score done by the batsmen Rahul and Sachin. Okay. Now according to problem, it is given that this run means the run done by both batsmen, 2x plus x, is equal to, they failed two short of a double century. So that will be 200 minus 2. They failed two short from a double century. That means 2x plus x means 3x is equal to 200 minus 2. That will be 198. So from here, what will be the value of x? So value of x will be 198 by 3. Now do the calculation. I think the result will be 66. Means the score done by Rahul is 66. Then find the score done by Sachin. So here write that Rahul's score is equal to 66 and Sachin's score is twice the Rahul's score, means 2 into 66. So multiply them. So if we multiply them, yes, 132. That means Sachin's score is 132 and Rahul's score is 66. Yes, very good. A lot of students has given the right answer. Rahul Sau, Aniruddha, Amnish, Saptarshi, Adrita. Very good. Okay, now tell me, Do you have any problem here? No problem. Okay. So now we'll move to the next question. Question number 3. You just read the question once. Question number 3, first question. Look, solve the following equation. Irfan says that he has 7 marble more than 5 times marble Parmeet has. Irfan has 37 marble. How many marbles does Parmeet have? Okay, so what Irfan saying? That he has 7 marble more. From what? From 5 times. For 5 times the marble Parmeet has. Okay, so we'll consider the Parmeet has x marble. Okay, so let us consider let Parmeet has x marble. Let Parmeet has x marbles. So what will be the number of marble of Irfan? So therefore Irfan's marble. Or you can say Irfan has how many marbles? Look, now to know this answer we have to read the question one. Irfan says that he has 7 marble more than 5 times the marble Parmeet has. So 5 times of the marble Parmeet has, so as Parmeet has x marble, so find the 5 times of x and 7 marble more. So Irfan has 7 more marble than 5 times of the marble Parmeet has. So 5x plus 7. Now according to problem, this is the number of marble Irfan has, but in your question it is given that the number of marble Irfan has is equal to 37. So this quantity and 37 must be equal. So according to problem, 5x plus 7 must be equal to 37. Now our equation is now ready. We have to solve it. Okay, so let's solve it. That means 5x is equal to 37 minus 7. That means x is equal to 5x is equal to 30, or x is equal to 30 by 5. That means x equal to, so what will be the value of x? Yes. So x is equal to 6. Okay, so x is equal to 6 is the answer. Okay, we know our time is now completed. Okay, but till I want to take 5 more minutes from you. Do you have any problem? No. Okay, then today this exercise will be completed. From next year we can start a new chapter. Okay, now question number 2. So Lakshmi's father is 49 year older. So Lakshmi is a girl. His father's age is 49 years. He is 4 year older than 3 times of Lakshmi's age. What is the Lakshmi's age? Okay, so let us consider the Lakshmi's age. Age is x here. So what is the his father age? It is given that his father is 4 year older than 3 times of Lakshmi's age. 4 year older than three times of Lakshmi's age. So his father's age. So his father's age will be 4 year more than 3 times of Lakshmi's age. So 3 times of Lakshmi's age, that is 3x, and 4 year more. So 3x plus 4. 3 times of Lakshmi's age plus 4. More 4. Okay. So according to problem, look, this is the age of his Lakshmi's father, but in your book, in your question, it is given that the Lakshmi's father's is 49 years. So according to problem, 3x plus 4 is equal to 49. Now from here we have to find out the solution. That means 3x is equal to 49 minus 4, or 3x is equal to 45, or x is equal to, if you do the calculation, the result will be 15. Yes, the result will be 15. Okay, that means the Lakshmi's age is 15 years. And he'll solve. Okay, so look, I am leaving the last two questions for you. Try to solve them by yourself. And if you can't solve them, then tell me in my next class, I will solve it for you. Okay? Yes, you have completed subclasses. That's a very good news. Very good. Okay, but those who have not completed it, try to solve it. If you can't, then tell me in my previous class. I will solve it for you. Okay? So, up to that, bye-bye. Take care.